的罰款機制呢，過往都是備受批評的，因為在早前的嚴重事故，譬如是四線壞車的事故來講呢，當時港鐵都只是計算同一班列車最長的延誤的時間，即是譬如那班列車原本是35分鐘就已經是走暈有一條路線的話，它最終走了一個多小時，那多了的時間呢，它就拿來計算個罰款的方程式，但就沒有反映到同一時間有幾個路線同時是出現事故，同埋那個事故所涵蓋的影響時段的長短。所以現在的罰款機制呢，是有結構性的漏洞的。今次港鐵撞車的事故呢，其實是很清楚令到整條荃灣線原本是兩分鐘一班的列車要延誤到去三分幾鐘一班列車。大家見到有很多是轉乘站呢，是往往出現很多的乘客是滯留，令到乘客是非常不便。我哋立法會鐵路事宜小組呢，在多次的會議，跨黨派的議員都是要求政府和港鐵要盡快去檢視現在的罰款機制，但很遺憾呢，政府這麼久以來呢，一路都是沒有付諸實行，令到這個罰款機制呢，是沒有辦法去反映到港鐵一些這麼嚴重事故最終是影響到乘客和服務的情況底下，那些罰款是完全反映不到個問題的嚴重性咯。我在這裡再次促請港鐵和運房局是應該要立即去檢討整個罰款機制，最重要的是考慮回個事故所影響的範圍、時段和嚴重性，絕對不可以用一些不合比例的方程式去對港鐵作小懲大戒咯。唔該曬。The penalty mechanism of MTR is problematic. Several political parties in the council strongly condemn the mechanism for so long, since it only calculate the delay period of a single line of MTR service, and which could not reflect the seriousness of those incidents. So we urge the government and MTR to promptly review the system and to revise it and to ensure the mechanism could fully reflect the seriousness of the incident.
How about in particular for the incident, how should the government approach it?
First of all, they have to amend the penalty mechanism first, and to ensure the any accident or incident happen later could reflect the seriousness of those incidents, particularly if any surface is affected by those incidents, and they have to also consider how many passengers and how long of those incidents, and to decide the penalty at last. Thank you.